My name is Bente Sætrang. I'm a textile artist. We are now in my studio in Oslo, in the outskirts of Oslo. It's called Frysja here. I've been working here since 1974. It has been a pleasure to be here, to work in such a nice place. So today there are about 50 artists working here. And we have been so lucky to have this place and to have such a predictable working situation. Many years ago, I was working with some chemical textile dyes, which I stopped working with many years ago, about 20 years ago. And then I wanted to take them back into consideration and see if I could find some new interesting traces to work with. Because these dyes, as you can see, they are quite clear and brilliant, and you can mix them in any recipe, in any mixture. And I like it so much that I had almost forgot how to use them. But as I have done so many other things during the years, I wanted to go back to this very start. And these are the dyes I learned to use when I during my education. So that's the very simple concept for the exhibition. I wanted to make about 10. I planned to make 20. I've made 35 pieces and then I made a choice of 10 for the show. Welcome to my exhibition in Kunstnerforbundet. It's in the center of Oslo city. This exhibition I've called it En rest av nødvendighet, and I've translated that into English like scraps of necessity. You can see some textiles, some printed textiles. This one I called Never Look Away. So two eyes looking into the exhibition. They are all the printed pieces done by silk screen printing technique and wet dyes. Progress of the work is interesting to me, so I very often try to leave some traces of this working process. You can see it's a very simple kind of composition made with silk screen. It's a silk screen print, and it is this rectangular form. It's printed twice, first a light pink, and then a darker pink, darker red, blue red, and the mix between them is important to get the right color. It is printed on a jacquard woven textile. It's a damask cotton, so you get this pattern which gives more to the color, because it's a light pink, light red, and a darker red, which is mixing in your eyes. So, and then I change the direction of the rectangular frame, and so you get those squares. This dye were developed in the 20s. 100 years ago, and it was used in like the Bauhaus. Bauhaus, Wiener Werkstätte, and it has a kind of historical melody for me, and for maybe for the result. The exhibition in Kunstnerforbundet is a mix of drawings and textile, printed textiles. There is a close connection in one way, but as I'm working with the textiles, I'm always doing drawings. So they are in a way the same thing, but in different materials and in different sizes. When I'm working with textile, I love to use more big sizes, like 3 meters by 3 meters or 3 meters by 150. And those pieces, are, from time to time, I'm getting fed up. So I need to go to a smaller format when I can work more directly and maybe make one or two every day and not one like this. I was spending like 3 months. It's different. It's a different way of working. Working on this exhibition started about 7 years ago. That was when I took up these old dies again. And I was just testing them. And I didn't plan an exhibition. Then I was invited to the exhibition in Kunstnerforbundet. And that's only 2 years ago. So then I started to really work on the exhibition as a show, and not only as pleasure of working, you know. It's a different kind of planning. If you ask me about what it means to make such a big exhibition, so then I must say that it is, it gives me nerves. And it gives me energy. And this is a paradox in every artist's real life. About a year ago, I started thinking of making a book so I could collect some parts of my working life in it. As I've been working in 40, 45 years, I have a lot and lots of pictures, and I have lots and lots of works, and I have a lot of experience as well. So I could, I love working with materials, and I like this the kind of head. So I wanted to make a book which could be a mirror of my way of working and way of thinking. And as I'm working, even if I'm working a lot, I'm working very slowly. So I can use weeks and weeks and weeks on one piece. Then I made an homage to a very young Moroccan who was killed by the Le Pen, the nationalists in Paris in 95. I came there the year after, and then I happened to be in a ceremony his friend was making at the banks of the River Seine. So I came back and I made this piece, which is a drapery as well, and it's made like it's like a heavy, heavy drapery. His friends were putting a white sheet on the banks of the river, and they threw flowers on the water. So that's why these are some white pieces and this very dramatic red color, and it is a drapery which is hanging in sorrow. And it is an homage to a young Moroccan, and there's his name was Brahim Bouaram. As I've been doing a lot of traveling in my life, I also wanted to make a text on the indigo color, which I was sort of exploring during a travel to West Africa. So I have written about the indigo color, and also about the situation in the Sahara Desert with the Tuaregs who have this beautiful color in their head scarves. So it's the indigo color, and when it is filled up, you can see it is it's almost like copper or bronze. It's shiny and beautiful. and it is full of indigo pigment, and it's easy to make, but you can make it under very primitive and simple circumstances, but it is so beautiful. So this is an homage to the color of indigo. I will probably start working again after a couple of weeks, but now I just need to pack the exhibition, to send it. I'm very happy. It was big sales for the National Museum, for the Parliament, for two other museums. I'm very happy about that. So now I need to make some new plans. I don't know if I will make another big exhibition. That's what I said last time I was in Kunstnerforbundet. That was in 12, 2, 8 years ago.